Hey everybody, welcome to the Sweet Feed and Row Hunting Resources. Well, Kansas archery turkey season starts on Monday. So we've been shooting and practicing, getting all of our gear ready to go. But one of the things, if you've been following us, you know, and you're watching our videos, you know that we, for turkeys, we use these head chopper style broadheads. This is the Magnus Bullhead. Now, we did, a couple years ago, we did a full length video on how to set these type of broadheads up, how to get them shooting right in the whole nine yards. Part of that is making sure that you have the correct spine and the length of your arrows so that way you can literally shoot bullet holes through paper, and so that your large diameter fixed blade broadheads are shooting just like your field tips. All right, now if you want to go back and review that stuff, go back and take a look at that full length video that we did. However, what I want to touch on here is, obviously I'm running a little GoPro on the bow right now. Well, given the popularity of filming your own hunts these days and how handy the little GoPro is with the little mounts that you can get, I'm gonna start playing around with filming off of the bow. If you're gonna do the same thing and you still want to use the head chopper style broadheads, keep in mind, any accessory that you put on your bow can and will affect how the bow reacts to the shot. That reaction, that change in reaction, can actually change how your bow torques and how your arrow leaves the bow. You may have a different arrow flight with a camera mounted on your bow, or even whether it's a decoy with a bow mount or just a new quiver, whatever. If you're gonna put accessories on your bow, you need to go back and start over and make sure that your field tips, the arrows that you're going to use during hunting, are shooting bullet holes through paper. That's what I've done this year. I went back to the drawing board and make sure everything is shooting right, and I did. I had to make a few slight adjustments because of the added weight and the different weight distribution on my bow was causing a little bit of a different torque, which was causing a little bit slightly different paper tear. So I corrected for it. Now we're rocking and rolling. We've got these babies dialed in out to 40, 50 yards, and they're flying like a dream. So just keep that in mind. If you want to put accessories on your bow and you still want to use these head chopper style broadheads, whether it's the bullheader or otherwise, go back, make sure you're shooting bullet holes through paper, make sure your large fixed blade diameter broadheads or large diameter fixed blade broadheads are shooting like your field tips. So that way when you get out in the field, you don't have any surprises.